Have you ever seen those so-called tele-evangelists who supposedly have the gift of healing? They prance around the stage and shout lots of hallelujahs and seem to push people over when they lay hands on them. I remember way back in my Bible college days, one of my fellow students asked our lecturer, a wise, godly Christian leader, about one particularly well-known so-called tele-evangelist. The question was this: do you think that God actually uses this guy to heal people? It's a good question. So the lecturer paused for a moment, cocked his head on one side as he thought about it, and momentarily, a glimmer of a smile emerged on his face, telling us he'd stumbled across a pearl of wisdom to answer what was a difficult question. Here's what he said. He said, "I have two parts to my answer, so hear me out. Do I think that God uses this man to heal people? Yes, I do. Absolutely, I do. But if I were God, would I use him to heal people? Not on your life." Good answer. Philippians chapter 1, verses 15 to 18. Some people are telling the message about Christ because they're jealous and bitter. Others do it because they want to help. They're doing it out of love. They know that God gave me the work of defending the good news, but those others tell about Christ because of their self-ambition. Their reason for doing it is wrong. They only do it because they think it'll make trouble for me in prison. But that doesn't matter. What's important is that they're telling people about Christ, whether they're sincere or not. So I am glad that they're doing it. I will continue to be glad. Should we be discerning? Absolutely we should, lest we be led astray. Yet our discernment can quickly turn into judgmentalism. Sometimes people do things in God's name out of wrong motives. But God is above all that. His thoughts aren't our thoughts. His ways aren't our ways. I love Paul's response. Even though they were taunting him while he was locked up in a dungeon on death row, he decided to leave it in God's hands, to let God work it out. A bit like my wise old lecturer. Be discerning, yes, but don't be judgmental. That's God's word, fresh for you today.